Hello and welcome to our new series of videos on endocrine physiology. In this video, we are going to talk about hormone classification and synthesis. First, we need to talk about how hormones are classified. We distinguish three basic classes: peptides and proteins, steroids, and amines. The difference between peptides and proteins is that proteins consist of 100 or more amino acids, whereas peptides have less than 100 amino acids. Peptide hormones are, for example, the growth hormone, prolactin, adrenocorticotropic hormone, or insulin. Steroid hormones are, for example, cortisol, aldosterone, testosterone, or progesterone. And amine hormones are, for example, norepinephrine or epinephrine. We'll talk about the individual hormones in the upcoming videos. Right now, let's only focus on their synthesis. Most hormones are peptides or proteins, so we'll start with their synthesis first. The first thing that needs to happen is that in the nucleus, the gene for the hormone we want to synthesize is transcribed into mRNA. This mRNA then goes to the cytoplasm, where it is translated on ribosomes. Here we get the first product, the so-called preprohormone, which has a signal peptide on one of its ends. The preprohormone then travels to the endoplasmic reticulum. Here, the signal peptide is removed, and we now talk about the prohormone. This prohormone goes to the Golgi apparatus, where the peptide sequence is further modified, and the final hormone is put into secretory vesicles and is ready for secretion. When the hormone is needed, secretory vesicles simply fuse with the cell membrane, and the hormone is secreted. So as you can see, the synthesis uses a lot of organelles in the cell. If you feel confused, then I recommend checking out our videos on cell physiology, where we talked about the individual organelles and their functions, which would certainly help you. Now we'll move to the synthesis of steroid hormones. All steroid hormones are synthesized from cholesterol, which is modified in different ways. Steroids are highly soluble in lipids, so when the hormones are synthesized, they can simply diffuse through the cell membrane and start working. Just to remind you, substances soluble in lipids can cross the cell membrane because they just dissolve in its hydrophobic lipid bilayer. Finally, we have the synthesis of amine hormones. We further divide amine hormones into catecholamines and thyroid hormones. The main catecholamines are epinephrine and norepinephrine. Thyroid hormones are thyroxine and triiodothyronine. Calcitonin is also produced by the thyroid gland, but it's a peptide. Thyroid hormones are synthesized in the thyroid gland, and they then form macromolecules with thyroglobulin. Together, they are stored in the gland until the hormones need to be secreted. They then split from thyroglobulin and are released. Epinephrine and norepinephrine, on the other hand, are formed in the adrenal medulla, where they are stored in vesicles until they are secreted through exocytosis. We also covered exocytosis in one of our videos, so I recommend you check that out. Okay, so this is it for the hormone synthesis. I hope you found this video useful and that it helped you as an introduction into endocrine physiology. For more videos on physiology or medicine in general, please subscribe. Thank you again, and until next time, don't forget that medicine can be easy.